Day 9, Saraswati Puja, a day dedicated to the goddess of learning, Saraswati. Tamil Nadu celebrates Saraswati Puja, just as yesterday West Bengal celebrated Durgashtami. Saraswati Puja, as is so apparent from its name, is a day of prayer to the goddess of learning, Saraswati. Today, we move into another room, which is also the penultimate installment of what we are going to see of my edition of the Bommakolu for the year 2021. We start off with a set of Ganeshas. Again, in all his grandeur, you have a Bhojanapriya Ganesha here. Then you have absolutely small looking Ganeshas over here. I hope the nuanced ones are captured on camera. They're extremely tiny but pretty looking Ganeshas here. There's a Ganesha over here in a Natya pose. Then there is Ganesha with his favorite foods here. Modak, you can see the fruits. There's the mouse. He's here playing with the mouse. And he's sitting with Grandia, with the Hamsa, with the Shanku in his hand. A Ganesha who's reading. We have another version of this which we saw a couple of days ago. He's sitting in the stand below. We saw him in the context of the various professional Ganeshas we had. This is another favorite area of my collection for me. A number of Ganeshas, all made in metal. They're amazing in their form, in their content, the way the men have created it, the artists who created it. Must be amazing talent that has made this possible. I really hope each one of them are getting captured in Dattu's camera work. There are other idols of Durga, Shiva, and Ganesh sitting there, non-metal. There is a metal Ganesha which has diyas at the bottom, lamps in between. And then there is a clay-made Ganesha painted in green. Now we move to some amazing woodwork Ganesha, multicolored, which I picked up. I think it's made in Kondapalli because I picked it up from Vijayawada. It's a Panchamukha Ganesha. There are two Panchamukha Ganeshas you will see in the same, at both ends of this row. There's a dancing Ganesha right in the center. And you have five musicians. To whose tunes probably the center Ganesha is dancing. Three on one side, two on the other on musical instruments. You have another Ganesha sitting there in ease, watching the dancing Ganesha. And as I said, an amazing Panchamukha Ganesha made of wood, again picked from Vijayawada and from Kondapalli. There are two more Ganeshas at the edge of that row. And you come down to row 2, where you have again two dancing Ganeshas at two extreme ends and one at the other extreme. We now come back to seeing a set of four musical Ganeshas, yellow and green in theme, and then even the Mushikas are in a musical mood over there, next to the Ganeshas. Then a dancing Ganesha, and a set of four dancing Ganeshas. You must look at the expressions on their faces, made with such delight by the artists who have made it. This end, and one at the other extreme. We We now come back to seeing a set of four musical Ganeshas, yellow and green in theme, and then even the Mushikas are in a musical mood over there next to the Ganeshas, then a dancing Ganesha, and a set of four dancing Ganeshas. You must look at the expressions on their faces, made with such delight by the artists who have made it. The next three rows, four, are Ganeshas of different colors and shapes and moods. Many of them are musical. You see some of them, most of them are saffron or dark black. Has a lot of Ganeshas, two of them sitting in an inclined, enjoyable siesta mood and listening to a set of performing Ganeshas. At the other side of the same divide, we have a dark brown and saffron tinged set of Ganeshas, and three at the other end in a nice green. The next row we have three Ganeshas made of wax. Three Ganeshas made of wax, green, orange, and a multicolored one in the center. Apart from which we have all small size Ganeshas. This set of Ganeshas are so small and minute ones in the front rows and slightly bigger ones made of terracotta in the back row. The entire terracotta Ganesha set are a dozen Ganeshas, and then you have about 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 different sets of musician Ganeshas over there. Come now to the last row of Ganeshas, a very slim looking Ganesha, and then the Ganesha in his usual mold, a pink dressed Ganesha, another set of three Ganeshas in musical mood, and we'll sign off with a few. One made in marble, one sitting over the serpent, Ganeshas. There is just one more theme we will deal with before we sign off for the day. And this is Draupadi Vastra Bharanam. In the court of the Kauravas, you see the Pandavas sitting below. They've just lost the famous game of chess. And Dharmaraja has given up all his property. As the epic would depict, Draupadi is brought to the Mahasabha, where you see the famous, all the great wise men, sages sitting as mute witnesses. Krishna coming to the rescue of Draupadi as you come further. And you have Dushyasana with his back to the camera pulling this upper sari of Draupadi. This is a new set we have this year acquisition and set completely by Dattu. So, day 9, thanks for being with me for all these 8 days. A very happy Dashera to all my, specifically my Tamilian friends who celebrate Saraswati Puja as the most important day of this festival. I hope you've enjoyed this show. Thank you, Dattu and Abhinav, as I sign off on day 9 with the promise to see you for one last time on this episode with this episode and into tomorrow for the last of this entire initiative on the Bommalakollu. See you tomorrow. Wishing you a happy Dussehra in advance. Bye-bye.